Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. A fallen Marine from Derry is about to come home for the final time. A procession will carry the body of Lance Corporal Michael Geary from the Manchester-Boston Regional Airport to his hometown of Derry. It will pass by Pinkerton Academy, where the 20-year-old graduated from last year. The school says the entire student body will gather outside in Geary's honor. He died last week in Afghanistan. A wake will be held Thursday in Londonderry. Friday's funeral will be in Derry, followed by a burial at the Veterans Cemetery in Boscawen. The case against a former Boy Scout leader charged with possessing child pornography is moving forward to Superior Court. Sean Neary appeared in court today, and our Ray Brewer was at his hearing.
Shackled but wearing civilian clothes, former Boy Scout leader Sean Neary appeared in Nashua District Court and waived his right to hear the evidence against him. Neary is charged with two counts of possession of child pornography and one count of distributing the images. But the prosecutor says more charges are likely.
There were over 50 images that were discovered that were identified as child sexual abuse images.
In arguing for reduced bail, defense attorney Adam Bernstein said, while that may be true, that's not pertinent to today's hearing.
Those issues are not before the court. I think that right now as we stand, it's the three complaints.
Neary's bail is currently set at $25,000 cash only. The defense was seeking to have that converted to cash or surety, which would allow Neary to post a bond. Bernstein noted his client's long ties to the community. He also said they would not seek to change a bail provision that currently prohibits Neary from having contact with his two children. And Bernstein assured the court there is no risk of Neary failing to show up for court.
In order for my client to post such a bail, his family would have to post the home as collateral, so I don't believe risk of flight is an issue.
The judge declined to reduce bail, meaning it is likely that Neary will remain in jail as his case moves now to Superior Court. The man behind the biggest Ponzi scheme in state history is testifying at a state hearing today. Scott Farah told those in attendance, including some of his victims, that he did take several steps to avoid regulation involved with financial resources mortgage. Back in October, Farah pleaded guilty to federal charges related to a scam that bilked investors out of $33 million. We'll have more on today's hearing starting on News 9 at 5. New Hampshire's first female chief justice will be sworn in this afternoon. Linda Delanus was appointed to the court 10 years ago as the state's first female associate justice. Governor John Lynch nominated her to succeed retired Chief Justice John Broderick, who now serves as Dean of the University of New Hampshire Law School. And a reminder that tonight we will be airing our one-on-one interview with Senator Judd Gregg, who bid farewell to Washington yesterday after three terms in office. He'll talk about his legacy and his future on News 9 at 6 and 11. Our conversation with the senator will continue on Close Up. Join us for that on Sunday at 10 a.m. And starting today, we are teaming up with an organization in need. WMUR is partnering with Shaw's Grocery Stores to help the New Hampshire Food Bank. We'll be live all day outside the Shaw's on South Willow Street in Manchester, helping to collect food. The drive will run through the weekend, giving you plenty of time to come down to any Shaw's in New Hampshire and make a donation. Well, starting tonight at 5 o'clock, drop-side cribs have caused more than 30 infant and toddler deaths in the past decade. Find out what a vote in Washington today means to the future of these cribs. And yogurt maker Danon is paying for the claims it made on some of its products. Find out what the yogurt company was saying to warrant a $21 million settlement. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon.